Hello, this is Chad with Syncfusion, and in this video, I'm talking about BoldSign, one of our SaaS apps. And actually, I'm going to talk about how you can set up very quickly as a POC, set up using our eSignature API. So let's get into it. Here is BoldSign. This is our website, and today I'm going to talk about our eSignature API. This, not that. This guy right here is what I'm talking about today. And how does that actually look? So I'll show you the app. This is the app that I'm going to walk through today. We are using the BoldSign API, and we have added the NuGet package into the application. It's right here. So let's go take a look at the NuGet package and see a little more details about that. Here's our NuGet package. As you can see, we do support pretty much everything .NET. And if you're going to use it on, if you're going to build this on a Mac, then we have these guys here that can help you along your way. Okay. And today what I'm going to be using is, well, today what I'm doing is I'm actually going to use this API to build a very small little console app to get this thing up and running. And then I'll show you the results. But here we go. So we have these are the two things that we're using. And within that, you have the client, the document client, the file path, the form fields. All of these are from our API. So we're going to create our API client here. And this is the website that we're using. Again, this is just a web API interface for you to develop your own apps against our SaaS application here. And to do this, we need a key. So let's go back to the web page and let's see about getting a key. So when you log into your BoldSign, this is the interface you get. And as you can see, I'm not very active in BoldSign. This is where I've been playing around with this application. But we're going to go down to the API section and we're going to click on API key and we're going to generate a key. And for this particular video, I'm going to make it expire on Tuesday. So my key is going to expire. I won't be able to use it. I will not be able to use it after this date. Here's my key. And let's copy it. Okay, let's go back to our app and put it in there. So there we go. There's our key. It is in the app. Now we need to create a client. We need to create a file path. This file path here is a local, it's just part of the project, a local file. You can pull this out from an FTP site, from just any web location. It's just somewhere that we can go and get the particular file you want to use. That's all this is. It doesn't have to be an actual file path. Then we're going to add signature fields. Now this file, actually, here's the file. This is what the file looks like. That I'm going to be sending. It's an employment offer. And here at the bottom is where I'm going to put the signature field. It goes right there. Okay. So, and that's what I'm doing here. I'm adding the signature field. It's going to be required. It's a signature type, and it is in this location. That's where it's going to be on the page. So I create the signature fields. I add the signature fields to our form fields collection. So yes, you can have as many fields as you wish on this document. Then I'm going to define who the signer is. In this case, again, this is just a quick POC. So there's only one signer in here and it's going to be sales engineers. Then we're going to create syn for a signature. It's just something you do with our API. And in this, there's going to be a message and a title. And I'll show you how that's used in just a little bit. I'm going to create the client and send document. This is the bit that actually tells the BoldSign to take it from here and to get everybody to sign it. So let's run this and see how it looks. Now something that we did here, and I wanted to write the document ID. So this is the document ID that is stored in our SaaS site. You can come and get this yourself. we don't have access to it. Okay, so let's go look at what this looks like. Here is my email. This is the email that was sent to me. Now it pulled this out. This information came out because I used my API key. So it knew who I was. I was already in the system. It's going to send this out. The title goes here. There's a message that goes here. This is the message that you added. And this is the signer name that I put. So these three fields came from here. The title, the message, and the name. Now, if I look at this, and I'm going to copy the link, open it in this one. So here it is asking me to sign it. It was sent by me. I'm going to say yes and continue. So here is a signature field, and I get to sign it. I actually like this one. So we'll save and use. And there it is, completely signed document using our eSignature API. So using our eSignature API right here. So it was just that simple. And thank you for watching.